should start off by saying that the Storm Petrel project was a huge team effort. Forest and Bird was well represented with Karen Baird and Sue Maturin. Right. Now, I hope I won't get ahead of myself with this not being able to see the screen, but in this presentation, I will talk about the important bird area program. This is a BirdLife international-driven program, and how this has been used to highlight global importance of sites and planning processes, in particular, you know, the Hauraki Gulf Spatial Plan, but also the Auckland Unitary Plan, and one or two others. Okay, important bird areas, or IBAs, are sites that are recognised as internationally important for bird conservation and are known to support key bird species and other biodiversity. To have such sites recognised as IBAs provides objective endorsement of their global importance. Now, global criteria used for the IBA process, similar to those used for Ramsar wetland sites. A1 and the A4 ones are very important for us. We have a lot of threatened species, a lot of threatened seabirds. We also have a lot of endemic species. So, you know, when you're looking at 1% of the global population, well, you know, we have a lot of IBAs. Right, elsewhere in the world, the general approach has been to look at all bird populations and identify IBAs on that basis. And by that I mean, you know, seabirds, waders, terrestrial species, and so on. Well, here in New Zealand, where seabirds make up over half our endemic and native bird species, identifying IBAs for seabirds first and foremost recognises New Zealand's rich and diverse seabird fauna. How rich? Well, our planet is home to over 10,000 species of birds. Ocean covers over two-thirds of the Earth's surface, and yet there are only 350 species of seabirds worldwide. And 86 of those breed in New Zealand. So the program today has been led by Forest and Bird, BirdLife International's New Zealand partner, with considerable support from both OSNZ, Birds New Zealand, and the Department of Conservation. Well, Forest and Bird, jointly with those other, with BirdLife and also OSNZ, published this document last year. That's this one here. It's available online. The last of the printed copies are sitting on the table outside. If you don't have one, grab one. Now that backgrounds the whole IBA process, but it also acts very much as an advocacy resource for seabirds, their lives and the threats they face. Now besides the main IBA document, there are three supplementary reports. Now these reports profile all the IBAs identified to date. This is for seabirds. Relating to seabirds. The first of these was published last year, is available through the Forest and Bird website, and that's marine IBAs, it's the one on the right-hand side, sites at sea. And the other two, I'll be finalising over the next 3 months. Auckland. This map shows the IBAs identified for the Auckland region. Now remember, these are sites of global importance for seabirds. A real concentration of important breeding sites. The map also shows the marine IBA on both coasts, where a number of key species forage and feed out to the continental shelf, out across the continental shelf. Those IBAs also, those marine IBAs also capture the movement in and out of those colonies of the birds that feed well offshore, birds like Cook's petrels and so on. So in terms of the Hauraki Gulf Spatial Plan, as we've been hearing, seabirds are very much an important component. Now, as Katrina was saying, C-Sketch is the GIS tool that is being used for this process. And this map shows where seabirds breed in the Hauraki Gulf, within the Hauraki Gulf Marine Park, showing species richness, and that is the number of species breeding at each site. Now, if we look at the distribution at sea, this is based on modelling that I've done from at-sea observations made from 2003 pretty much to the present. And we've done some predictive modelling right across the whole area. And you can show how seabirds use basically the whole of the marine park. Now, combine that with the colony data and also the shorebird sites, the purple areas around the fringes, and you can see how important the Hauraki Gulf Marine Park area is for these species. Now, running concurrently with the Hauraki Gulf plan is the proposed Auckland Unitary Plan process. And Forest and Bird, along with EDS, or Environment Defence Society, have a major submission to this. Now, the Unitary Plan process, ambitious and complex as it is further complicated because the Auckland Council District Plan, the Hauraki Gulf Islands section, still applies and will continue to do so until the proposed Auckland Unitary Plan is amended to fully integrate the Hauraki Gulf Islands. Well, what this has meant is that a key component of the region's biodiversity, the actual islands themselves above Marine High Water Spring, which as you've seen are critically important for seabirds and a raft of other biodiversity, cannot be discussed fully at the independent plan hearings. Now, in terms of looking at the region's biodiversity, the key component to this is the identification of significant ecological areas, or SEAs. These are both on land and in the marine area. So the green hatched areas are SEAs identified on land, the terrestrial ones, and obviously the blue ones, SEAs. Marine are in the water. The map is from the Whangaparoa Peninsula, it's Tiritiri down here, up to Kawa Island. Now, taking a broader view, and remember the Hauraki Gulf Islands are not covered in the current Unitary Plan process, and you can see there's a lot of the Auckland coastal marine area, which is, if you took this map at face value, is devoid of ecological significance. Now, the draft plan currently states, and I'll quote, the CMA, or the coastal marine area, has not been comprehensively surveyed for the purpose of identifying SEA marine. In particular, the identified SEA marine areas may underrepresent significant marine communities and habitats present in the subtidal areas of the region. Additionally, larger coastal marine areas with ecological significance, such as the Hauraki Gulf, the Kaipara and Manukau harbours, are difficult to map for a number of reasons, including because of their scale and the highly mobile habits of marine fauna. And different management responses are required for the range of activities which might adversely affect the significant ecological values of these areas. And therefore, a precautionary approach is required to manage effects in the coastal environment, as well as ongoing work to increase understanding of the characteristics and values of that environment. And that's the end quote. Well, it's vital that threatened marine species, including those seabirds, are recognised. But to date, we don't have that any indication of what those different management approaches might be. Okay, a little respite from all those SEAs and IBAs and PAP, whatever, spatial plans. These are some of the seabirds, and you've seen this photograph before, for which the Auckland CMA and the Hauraki Gulf is globally important. Tim told you about the New Zealand storm petrol. I don't need to fill you in on that one. Black petrol. Whole world's population. Breed on Great Barrier, Little Barrier. Cook's petrol. 98% of the world's population breeds on Little Barrier Island. There's a smaller population on Great Barrier. White-faced storm petrel. Now, it's not a threatened species, but a significant proportion of the population breed in the Hauraki Gulf area. And I've included this image because it's a reminder that the seabirds that breed on land, well, they breed on land, and that the petrels in shearwaters are nocturnal, moving between the sea and their nest sites. We've heard about how the black petrel is affected by fisheries bycatch. The flesh-footed shearwaters, large populations, significant populations breed in the Hauraki Marine Gulf, Marine Park area. It's a bird that is also impacted heavily by both by commercial and recreational fisheries. Buller's shearwater. The whole world's population breeds on one group of islands, the Poor Knights Islands. It's outside the spatial plan area, but there are significant presence within the marine park. New Zealand fairy tern. New Zealand's rarest bird, and arguably the world's rarest seabird, threatened by coastal development activities. And this flock of prions and shearwaters. So translate those images with those images in mind. These maps are not just colours on the screen. Add Rochelle and her team's marine mammal sightings for good measure. And we will be working hard to convert those blank areas into areas of global, national, and regional significance. Well, there's other plans underway around the country. There's one in Northland, Marine Plan. There's ongoing hearings in relation to aquaculture development in the Marlborough Sounds. There's the Hurunui District Plan. And this one for the Otago Coast, the Southeast Marine Protection Forum. Now, the important area in seabird colony database, the one that underpinned the IBA program, has been used to provide key information about seabirds and the use of the marine area. The key trigger species in this case are yellow-eyed penguins, Stewart Island shags, and also Northern Royal Albatross. Now this plan also uses the Sea Sketch tool. And IBAs and the land and both on land and at sea figure along with all the breeding sites. Now SeaSketch is an interactive tool. You add this layer, which shows the annual set net activity along the coast, that is outside the set net ban area inshore, which is inside that along the coast there. And you can see how vulnerable those trigger species are or could be to such fishing activity because the areas overlap. So in summary, important bird areas or IBAs recognize globally important sites for birds and other biodiversity. IBAs identified for seabirds and other coastal birds give effect to the New Zealand Coastal Policy Statement, Policy 11. Birds capture people's imagination. While ecosystems have increasingly taken priority in conservation management planning, iconic and highly threatened bird species can help drive the broad support we need to protect critical habitats. Thank you.